Hi everybody, my name is Allison Camp and I'm the Curriculum Director for Fruitport Community Schools. The purpose of these videos is to provide you some more information about what our fall is going to look like. We know you have a big decision to make in terms of if you want to send your students back to face-to-face instruction or if you would prefer to opt into the online options that we are providing. So hopefully these videos will help you make a more informed decision. If you have any other questions after watching these videos, my contact information will be at the end of the video, and you are welcome to reach out to me at any time to receive additional information. This video will talk through what our plan is if the state is in phase four, which is when schools are allowed to be open but with restrictions. To build our plan for all of the phases, we got a group of teachers and administrators together and set up meetings throughout the summer to take apart the Safe Schools roadmap that was released by the governor and develop our plan for each section. Unlike phases 1 through 3, phase 4 has been very tricky to plan for. At this point, the state lets the schools make whatever decisions they would like to, and school districts are of course making different decisions, which can lead to some controversy. It's also tough for us to balance the health, safety, economics, and politics of all of our stakeholders. And we know that there is not one decision that will make every stakeholder happy. We use these tenets to guide the development of our plan. Spring surveys indicated that most families wanted in-person instruction. We had to consider the safety of our students and our staff. We know that there are challenges for families with two working parents and guardians. We know that in many cases, face-to-face instruction is a better option than online learning for most students. We also had to consider the resources and facility constraints that we had to work within and the requirements of the information from the governor and from the health department. Since you're curious about what school will look like this fall, about 55% of our kids typically ride the school bus. So K-12 students will all need to wear masks on the bus. Some masks will be provided in case students forget to bring their mask with them on the bus. K-12 kids will also need to use hand sanitizer before getting on the bus. Those have been mounted on the buses and they are ready for the fall. Kids will be sitting together like normal, but in assigned seats. Some of the arrival procedures have changed slightly in our buildings, and those are detailed at the bottom of this slide. Here are some additional school day protocols that might be different than what we're typically used to. Water fountains will be turned off, but bottle fillers will be on. Students will have their typical schedule. So for example, kids will attend gym, art, music, STEM, etc. There will be hand sanitizers in every room and throughout the building, including in high use doors that are used for example, entrance or recess. Hand washing will be incorporated into the student's day, especially at the elementary level. Our PBIS lessons will include proper hygiene techniques and what to do and how to properly wear masks. Students will likely be needed to help wipe down their desk or materials between use. This will be mainly important at the secondary level. Visitors, including parents, will be very limited this year. That we will not be allowed to have any assemblies or field trips, and high school will need to have a closed campus for lunch. All of those safety protocols have been put in place to allow us to have face-to-face instruction. At the elementary level, that face-to-face instruction will be 5 days a week. We are going to have teachers remove all but the essential materials in their classrooms in order to maximize the space between desks. K-5 students will need to wear their masks all day, including recess, but excluding lunchtime and when teachers are providing mask breaks throughout the day. We are going to ask that all students have their own pencil box of essential school materials. If you cannot purchase those on your own, the school will provide those for your child. Additionally, staff members will need to wear masks all day. At the middle and high school level, the face-to-face instruction will look a little bit different. So the typical secondary teacher sees about 125 students per day, and we wanted to limit the amount of exposure, not only between the students, but between students and staff. So we put the students in a cohort model that would cut down the students in the building on any given day in approximately half. So we are looking to split the students alphabetically and develop a cohort A with half the students, and those students would attend school on Monday and Thursday and do remote learning on Tuesday and Friday. Cohort B students would be on the opposite schedule. They would be attending face-to-face on Tuesday and Friday and do remote learning on Monday and Thursday. All students would be remote on Wednesday. The reason we did that instead of having students rotate 3 days a week and 2 days a week was to create consistency for families. In this model, a family would know that they are going to school on set days every week instead of a rotating set of days week to week. All of our K-12 students will need to wear masks every day, and that includes our teachers as well. We feel like this model will also set our students up so that if we do fall back as a state into phases 1 through 3, some of those remote learning structures would have already been put in place. Probably one of the biggest questions that we've been receiving lately is about why we are having our K through 5 students wear their masks all day. And I just wanted to point out some of the language that the governor gave us related to K-5 students. And it says that they must wear facial coverings unless they are in their classes throughout the school day. And since a large majority of our students will be riding the bus together, eating in the cafeteria together, and playing at recess together, we are going to be requiring them to wear masks all day, not only for their safety, but for the safety of their teachers. Additionally, we have learned that if a student were to inadvertently come to school with COVID, because they are all wearing their masks, it would limit the number of students and staff that would have to be quarantined as a result. Additionally, if a parent has a child that they believe is medically unable to tolerate a mask, there will be a form available for parents to fill out and doctors to sign so that we can find a reasonable accommodation for that child. Soon, we will release the protocols that have been established by the health department for what we are to do if a student or staff member comes down with COVID, or we become aware that they were sick with COVID during the school day. So some families might not be quite ready yet to send their children back to face-to-face instruction while in phase 4, and for those families we are providing an online option. This online option is meant to mimic or imitate what a student would be receiving in face-to-face instruction, and as such it will require students to spend 4 to 6 hours per day on the computer completing their coursework. Students at the elementary level will be assigned 4 courses, the 4 core courses, math, ELA, science, and social studies. Secondary students, we are going to be setting up a schedule that is very similar to the courses that they were scheduled for in their face-to-face environment, either at the middle school or their high school. The instruction or teacher is provided by the vendor. We're looking at Odysseyware and or Michigan Virtual at the secondary level, and Edgenuity or Edmentum for the elementary level. Fruitport will assign each student a mentor who will check in with that student 1 to 3 times a week depending upon the level of support they need to complete their coursework. Parents that opt for this option will need to make a full semester commitment. Our semester ends at the end of January. And in addition, at the K-5 level, the parent will have to act as a learning guide for some of the activities required within the online tool. There have been additional questions that have come up about the online learning environment, and those questions with their appropriate answers are on this slide. For the sake of the length of the video, I will not read through these. Please pause the video and read through them as needed. Thank you so much for listening to this video. All of the information that has been provided is tentative until final board approval on August 12th. If you do have any questions related to the content of this video, you are very welcome to reach out to me using the contact information on this slide. Thank you again for your time.